Ever since Edwin Hubble discovered that the universe is expanding, there has been a great debate about the speed of this expansion, also called the Hubble constant. In 2000, scientists thought they had reached a consensus, with the Hubble constant at about 72. But since then, two methods of calculating the expansion rate have gotten farther and farther apart, and some scientists think it's too big of a difference to just be a statistical fluke. To calculate the Hubble constant, we need both a velocity and a distance. Velocities are easy. It requires measuring the redshift of a galaxy as it recedes. But distances are much harder. We need standard candles, objects that shine with an intrinsic brightness. That way, its observed brightness could be converted to a distance. The first method used to calculate the Hubble constant originated with Hubble himself. He started by measuring distances to nearby objects and working his way out, hence the name the cosmic distance ladder. The first rung is within our Milky Way. Here we measure the distances to Cepheids, pulsating stars that have an intrinsic brightness. Then we look to nearby galaxies that contain both Cepheids and another type of standard candle, Type 1a supernovae. These exploding white dwarf stars also have an intrinsic brightness. After calibrating these supernovae, astronomers can then move out to a third rung, to even more distant galaxies that only contain supernovae. Linking all these measurements, a recent study has pinned the Hubble constant at 73. Instead of starting within our galaxy and looking out, the second method looks back in time to almost the beginning of the universe. Here we find the cosmic microwave background, the radiation left over from the Big Bang. The CMB's subtle variations in temperature describe changes in the density of the universe right after the Big Bang. Instead of standard candles, physicists use the size of the tiny fluctuations as standard yardsticks. With these yardsticks, they can calculate what the Hubble constant would be today. Recent estimates are at about 68, significantly lower than the cosmic distance ladder's approach. Both camps hope to resolve this debate in the coming years with the help of new telescopes and instruments. But if the discrepancy in the Hubble constant remains, it could mean that our understanding of the expansion of the universe is missing an ingredient, that something happened between the Big Bang and the present. Maybe there's a neutrino out there we haven't discovered. Maybe the mysterious force, dark energy, which makes up a significant portion of our universe, can change in strength. Or maybe subtle flaws in one or both approaches to the Hubble constant are giving us the wrong answer.